Greetings. I'm calling this video part 1B of the series. There was some unfinished business from part 1. After making part 1, it occurred to me that someone, particularly a Muslim apologist, may think, "Aha! Texas, the Muslims were not afraid. They intentionally wanted to obey the Prophet's message." No one has actually made this argument. I'm just thinking it through, the way I would attack part 1 if I were Muslim. But would a Muslim brick up the gate to fulfill the message of Prophet Ezekiel? Now, if the vision and prophecy of Prophet Ezekiel were to say, "And the faithful servant of Allah shall close the gate, because the Prophet of Allah has passed through the gate." If Ezekiel had seen this in the vision and said this, shutting the gate might be an act of Islamic obedience. Psst, he did not. But if one actually considers the whole of the prophecy, this line of argument and dua makes no sense. Point one of the prophecy: Jehovah God will enter in through the gate. Point two: the gate will then be closed because of that, out of awe or respect for God. He has made the gate holy. Point one: could a Muslim respect or believe that Almighty God had physically entered the gate? And in particular, that gate? No. They believe Allah is impotent to enter His creation. No Muslim would believe that such an event could ever occur. Certainly, they would not believe it had already occurred. Point two: the gate will be closed because of that, out of the awe or respect for God. The only reason to close the gate as an intentional act of attempting to fulfill this prophecy would be if someone believed that God had already passed through it. God goes through, then close the gate. One must believe God has gone through before one thinks it is time to close the gate. Could a Muslim believe that Almighty God had already physically passed through the Eastern Gate? No. First, God cannot enter His creation. Second, God cannot take human form. Third, no way Muhammad would have missed this. Why would any mind shaped and twisted by Islam and the Quran imagine that God the Creator had at some previous time somehow physically gone to Jerusalem? Wouldn't Allah tell Muhammad, setting the record straight and all, with the last prophet? Maybe that is the lost ayat of Surah 17. Surah 17:1. Glory to Allah, who did take His servant for a journey by night from the sacred mosque to the farthest mosques, whose precincts we did bless. Now he says we did bless, we meaning Allah did bless the precincts He visited. Shouldn't that have had the complete sentence of when we did ourselves pass through the east gate? Otherwise, how did Allah bless the precincts of the farthest mosque? In order that we may show Him some of our signs. What sign would He have left when He went through the gate? I don't know. But surely He is the one who hears and sees all things, it says. So why did Muslims erase when we did ourselves pass through the east gate? That leaves you thinking. Maybe Allah was embarrassed and abrogated this because it looked a little prideful. Maybe this verse had nothing to do with Jerusalem. After all, the city name is never used. Or maybe the Allah of the Quran is not the God of Israel, Jehovah, who said He would pass through the gate and did pass through the gate. I cannot think of a single valid argument supporting a Muslim closing the East Gate in defense or support of Ezekiel's vision. Given that, I cannot believe any Muslim bricking up the wall did so intentionally to fulfill the prophecy. That does leave the possibility of other reasons which might convey coincidence on the Muslim's behavior and not invalidate the prophecy. If Muslims controlling Jerusalem were afraid of crusaders, for example, they might brick up gates as a final desperate measure against siege. However, it would seem consistent to brick all the gates instead of only the one, if that were the case. Close all the entry points into the city, and after the siege ends, all gates would be unbricked, opened up for use. Unless the Muslims in Jerusalem were attempting to boycott the Mount of Olives next door, an early BDS movement. But those clever Jewish olive sellers might realize the other three gates remained open. Could each Muslim that bricked up the gate along the way simply have gotten the order wrong? The Jewish God is coming. Quick, close the gate in his honor. Sorry, I can't even foist that with a straight face. But maybe a sincere, honest Muslim, seeing Jesus walking in, might just fall down at the feet of the Son of God and worship him, ignoring his orders to close the gate. Then said the Lord unto me, This gate shall be shut. It shall not be opened, and no man shall enter in by it, because the Lord, Jehovah, the God of Israel, hath entered in by it. Therefore it shall be shut. If the God of Israel has not yet entered in by it, don't shut it. He might stub his toe or bump his nose. Just don't do it. Given such consideration, even humorous, of Muslims claiming to brick the gate from other reasons than fear, just does not pass the sniff test. Fear of the God of Israel coming is the best, most believable explanation. Even if thinking bricks can stop God is inconceivably ridiculous. Now, I think I'll continue the next example in part 2 of this video series. It deserves a full video. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ, who passed through the Eastern Gate. Amen.